Good morning and welcome to the Berks County Board of Commissioners meeting for August the 23rd. We will begin with a moment of silence followed by a pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Are there any additions or corrections for the August 16th Commissioner meeting minutes? Seeing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. I'm going to take a minute here and sign the controller's office report. There you go.
Thank you.
Is there any public comment on specific agenda items? Seeing none, we'll move into the agenda. Under item one, authorizing commissioners adopt a resolution pursuant to a section of the Internal Revenue Code approving the financing by the Warnersville Municipal Authority of tax-exempt revenue bond in the amount not to exceed $10 million for the Diakon Lutheran Social Ministries to finance the refunding of certain outstanding debt of DLSM related to its several retirement communities, including the Lutheran home at Topton, and further authorizes the chair or any member of the board to execute any and all documents related to this transaction. This approval shall not in any way obligate the credit or taxing power of the county, nor shall the county be liable for the payment of the principal of or interest on any obligations issued by the authority. Mr. Edelman, you want to address this?
Thank you very much. Good morning,
Commissioner. Good morning.
This transaction is a refunding of existing indebtedness that Diakon incurred in 2009. Interest rates were still fairly high back in 2009. These bonds were sold with a 30-year maturity, so there's a fair amount still remaining outstanding. Diakon did enter into
a transaction a couple of years ago to refund a portion of these bonds, and they are now taking advantage, with interest rates still remaining fairly low, to refund the outstanding debt. It will generate substantial savings to them over the remaining term of the bonds. There's no new money involved in this transaction. The proceeds of the original bonds were used to finance capital improvements to their retirement communities, both here in Berks County at Lutheran Home at Topton, as well as their other facilities in eastern Pennsylvania. As noted, this approval is this sort of the standard requirement from the Internal Revenue Service, but there's no obligation for the county in any way with respect to the outstanding debt. You're just making a finding that this project is beneficial to the Diakon and the senior citizens that are served by Diakon and its many facilities.
Very good.
Thank you very
much. Any questions?
No. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
The next item under Budget Department, adopt a resolution authorizing 2018 budget transfers in the amount of $119,108 and 2018 appropriations in the amount of $20,417 per listing dated August 20th of 18. There are several items listed under Human Resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Amy Resch to Library Systems Administrator in the Library System. Item two, authorize the appointment of Aaron Howenstein to Outreach Services Coordinator, Library System. Item three, authorize the appointment of Samuel Mills to Assistant Public Defender 1 in the Public Defender's Office. Item four, authorize a salary adjustment for for Devin Schneck, Judicial Administrative Assistant in Court Administration. And then item two, a motion authorizing execution of contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator is set forth on the attached listing dated August the 21st of 2018. There are a total of 21 contracts. There are 7 contracts with the Area Agency on Aging. There's 1 contract with the Berks County Residential Center, 1 with the Berksheim, 1 with Career Link, 1 with the Community Reentry Center, 1 with the coroner, 1 with the courthouse, 1 with the Department of Emergency Services, 1 with the District Attorney, 1 with the Berks County Jail, and then 5 with mental health and developmental disabilities. And then finally, a motion to ratify and confirm payments is set forth on the Comptroller's Office voucher listing. It's dated for August the 21st of 2018 for the week ending August the 26th of 2018, and the payment of electronic transfers and employee payroll.
I'll motion to approve the agenda as presented.
I will second that motion. The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. With that, we'll turn to reports. We have Linda Weaver sitting in for our county treasurer with the county treasurer's report. Linda.
Good morning. Thank you.
Good morning.
We have an opening balance of $200,723,376.48. We have a balance to clear of $4,243,060.77, leaving us with a balance of $196,480,315.71.
Thank you very much. And then Sandy Graffius, our county controller, with the controller's report.
All righty. General accounts payable, $2,173,592. We had wire transfers of $2,755,748. We had a payroll this week, $4,285,011, for a grand total of $9,214,352.05.
Thank you very much. And we'll turn to our Chief Financial Officer, Mr. Bob Patrizio, with the agenda for this afternoon's budget and operations meeting.
Good morning, Commissioners. We do have a meeting today. It starts at 2 p.m. We're going to have a discussion about our annual discussion about municipal billing for our 911 services. Our Director Brian Gottschall will be here. We have Ed Balliot of CHR is attending to discuss efforts that we've made and maybe perhaps can be made and whatever obstacles might be with positioning Berksheim as a preferred short-term rehab facility. And we did add one item to the agenda yesterday at the request of our CAO. It's a follow-up discussion on our 2019 RX plan, follow-up to the discussion we had a few weeks ago.
Great.
That HR requested.
Very good. Yeah, interesting. Ed Balliot was one of the presenters at the CCAP annual conference workshop that I sat in, and actually Christine was in that workshop, and he discussed the preferred physical therapy status, and I'm very interested to see how that might be able to help with the revenue sources for the Berksheim. So. Good to hear that. With that, we will turn to Ron Seaman, our Chief Administrative Officer.
Thank you, Chairman Leinbach. I have nothing further to offer at this point.
Okay. Commissioner's reports. Commissioner Barnhart.
Ditto.
Aren't you going to talk about the Chamber Picnic and the Home Run Derby?
I thought maybe you would wax eloquently about that. I failed to respond appropriately to the Home Run Derby. I probably finished, I would suspect, dead last. But it's not my forte. I'm not a home run hitter. I'm not a baseball hitter. I'm more of a, I'm not really sure. But
hot dog eater.
You know what?
A great time was had by all.
And yes, he was a fantastic social. Sport. And
that's right.
We were thrilled to both be there.
Right.
And the reality is, in this home run derby, there were no home runs.
That's right.
No home run. And not only were there no home runs, I don't think there was anybody that was close to a home run.
As has been said many times, when you're down on the field, it's much longer than it looks in the stands.
That fence is far away. And then you add to it, the two of us were the oldest by far.
We should have had an under 50, over 50.
Yeah, we were 59. There were two guys in their 50s, 52 and 51. And then I think it was pretty much 30-ish, maybe even one there in the upper 20s. But
that was good, though.
It was a lot of fun. Chamber did a great job with the annual picnic at that location.
Thank you.
One item that I want to touch on, this Saturday, and again Sunday, there are two very closely related events. So on Saturday at 11 a.m., there will be a special ceremony at Stonecliff Recreation Park. That is the only county park physically within the boundaries of the city of Reading. It's known to many people as our skate park. But several years ago, we dedicated a plaque to the memory of Colonel Thomas Dugan. He is one of three POW MIAs from Berks County. This Saturday, through cooperation with the Ride for Freedom, POW MIA, Forget-Me-Nots, we are posting a Hometown Heroes banner next to the marker honoring Colonel Thomas Dugan. Some of the Dugan family will be there. Colonel Dugan was in the United States Air Force and shot down while on a mission over Vietnam. Interestingly enough, Colonel Pennebecker, Colonel Engstat, and Colonel Dugan are the three POW MIAs from Berks County. All three were U.S. Air Force. All three were shot down over Vietnam. On Sunday, we will be having the 25th annual Ride for Freedom. The Berks County Forget-Me-Nots are they a major sponsor of this event. The Reading Motorcycle Club is a major participant. I have participated, I think, almost every year that I've been here riding my motorcycle. But we're going to be starting down in Ole around 9 a.m., I believe at the Legion. I'm not sure. I don't have it in front of me. Going up to Wommelsdorf, stopping in Wommelsdorf for a break, and then leaving Wommelsdorf at 11 a.m. and coming straight up 422, which turns into Penn Avenue and then Penn Street, up to Veterans Grove at Reading City Park at the Vietnam Memorial, and there will be a special service there at 1 p.m. For those that want to come out. Maybe you don't want to ride a motorcycle, but you want to come out and be there for the special service. That takes place at 1 p.m. this Sunday. The weather looks like it will be very good. It's one of the most moving ceremonies I participate in. We will have a number of volunteers read over the list of all of the people from Pennsylvania on the POW MIA list. They read their name, their branch of service, and where they're from. And then the entire audience, after every single name, says, "Still missing, sir." It's a very, very moving service. If you've never been there, the 25th anniversary of this ride would be a great time to come out. And that's all that I have. Row officers, comments.
I'd like to share with Kevin, and I won't point out which one of my daughters did it, but one time when she was in second grade, she was not doing well. And I said to her, "Don't you realize if you don't pull yourself together, you're going to be last?" And she looked at me and she said, "Mother, someone has to be last."
I wondered where this was going.
Thank you, Sammy. You have added a spark to my day, recognizing that being last wasn't so bad.
But actually, he was first.
I was first batter, so I had to lead the way for everyone else to make sure they didn't do what I did.
And believe me,
yes,
that's tough to go first.
Mm-hmm.
So, Okay, with that, we will open up to any public comment. As always, if you would like to speak, step up to the microphone. Please give your name and where you're from, and we have a limit of 3 minutes.
I guess I have a couple clarification. Oh, sorry, it's Claudia Strauss, Berkshire Heights. Forgot to do that. Okay. First, the list of contract agreements, you mentioned a contract for Berksheim and a contract, did you say the residential center?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so the Berksheim one, is that with the management company, or what would that contract be?
No,
is that,
I mean, look
so
there.
For internet service.
You can comment on?
It is, the county is engaging the, well, you know what, ask your questions and then we'll go over the answers.
Okay, great. My other question is about the, I had asked a question a couple weeks ago about how much acreage is involved in the possible Berksheim sale. And I was told it was 30.84 acres. Wow. But was built in the 50s. That land was designated as 34.56 acres, so that's almost a 4 acre difference. So is that the 4 acres that the survey is about, when there was that question that was raised at some point about there being two surveys of land there as opposed to just one? I'm trying to understand why there's a discrepancy.
Fine. Anything else?
That's it.
Okay. Talk to Ron afterwards. See if you can figure out what the, I'm not even completely sure of your question, but just go over with Ron on what exactly you would like to know on the acreage.
Okay.
On the two contracts, and you can go ahead and be seated.
Thank you.
The first one, the Berksheim contract, the county is engaging a vendor to install, maintain, and operate bulk service cable communication systems to 277 outlets at the Berksheim Nursing and Rehab Facility for 5 years with automatic successive one-year renewals. Monthly bulk service rate is $10.92 per outlet. The residential center, the county is engaging the vendor to provide patient transfer service on an as-needed basis for residents of the Berks County Residential Center to St. Joseph Medical Center. There shall be no expense charged to the county for that service. So, someone else. And again, name and where you're from.
My name is Fred Fritch. I'm from Mertztown. I'd like to ask you to close the detention center. I'm very unhappy about what's happening there. You know, not going to get into all the politics about, around the world. I was a Vietnam era veteran. I didn't have to go. I was a jet engine instructor at tech school. I fixed the Phantom jets that the guys flew over there and probably could have gotten shot down. I talk to my friends who are vets. They cry all the time about the things they were asked to do. We're asking our employees to do that here in at this prison. It's a terrible policy. I've been at the motorcycle ride several years. It's an unbelievably moving event. I've cried. I played taps several times. I wasn't asked this year. But sometimes we get caught up in just what we do, and we need to think about what's wrong. Last night at 10 o'clock, I read a Facebook post about somebody's grandmother from Poland or somewhere over in the Nazi Germany, and all the things they have to do to try to outsmart bad laws and bad decisions, and we're part of that right now here in Berks County, and I'd like to ask you to change your policy on that and close it down, and the kids should be returned to their parents, and I don't even know who's in there, and maybe you don't either, but thank you for listening.
I assure you we know who is in there, and just before we go on to the next speaker, I will tell you that facility has been highly misrepresented. We've been in the facility numerous times. parents and children are together. They always have been. This is a facility that's been in operation for over 16 years. Right now, there are approximately 40 adults there, overwhelmingly from Guatemala with a few from Honduras. They do not speak Spanish. They speak a number of four or five different dialects. We have those. I can't pronounce the names of what they speak. The Berks County Intermediate Unit provides high-tech classrooms and education for all of the children. In addition, they provide English as a second language. Don't shake your head no. They absolutely do. The Reading Berks Conference of Churches, provides a chaplaincy program. We have the U.S. Surgeon General with approximately 24 employees and 24/7 service, a medical service, on a regular basis. I've been through the facility many times. Our employees do a great job, and it is a shame that it has been misrepresented the way it has. I'm not suggesting that you are intentionally misrepresenting it, but there have been folks that have, that know better, know what goes on there, and it's just simply not the case. But we do fortunately live in a country where people have a right to disagree, have a right to their opinion, and I welcome you in sharing your thoughts, and I would commend you for having the courage to stand up and share your opinions, even though it's not something I happen to agree with. So thank you very much. Yes, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Louise Legan. I live in Berks County in Blandon. I was an officer in the United States Air Force during the Vietnam era and served in Korea as the war was winding down. I know Fred. I've been involved in the same issue, and my concerns are that this facility hasn't been licensed by the state, that the county commissioners have been appealing this for years to try to get it licensed as a facility to serve families. I understand that it's not licensed for children. I'm also concerned that what's going on may not be made public, that we're not getting the full story. My other concern is that we talk about immigrants coming over illegally. In my opinion, there are some who are here as refugees. I consider and this has nothing to do with the county commissioners, but our foreign policies making it very difficult for people to live in the countries where they're living, and they're escaping with their lives for one reason or another, partly because of some of the financial policies, the NAFTA, the farmers in Mexico who are committing suicide because they can't farm their land like they did for centuries, with the U.S. selling their corn to Mexico at a loss to put the Mexican farmers out of business so they could take their land, all the policies that went on during the Reagan era with these right-wing juntas and killing people and overthrowing governments, which has been going on for all my life. So you stood and said the pledge to the flag. And if you think about what you said with liberty and justice for all, I don't see that happening. Thank you.
Thank you. Do you want to address the license?
No.
Okay. Anyone else?
I'm not getting it.
Okay.
Good morning. My name is Jim Beidler. I'm from Burton Township. And I wish you would spend half as much time figuring out something else to do with that family jail instead of wasting the time defending it like you did here today. You're both complicit. I'm ashamed to have you as my commissioners.
Thank you very much. Anyone else?
Hi, Crystal Kowalski, YMSing. I have a question about the survey. I want to know if it has been completed on those two parcels of land, and also if it has been completed, if someone would be able to show me where those parcels of land are, or if we could see if the public has access to that survey, I guess is the question. Thank you.
You have it? Okay.
Meet with Ron and Christine after
yeah,
me.
Same follow-up. Anyone else?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.